having a winning heat races. I'm sure you don't mind that at all.
Well, certainly don't. This is in fact my first group on the outside of Australian soil, so it's been great pleasure.
How long ago was it when you got first book you there?
Well, I was here for the international meeting and I won on him on that day when he was in a class 2 race for memory, and he then said, well, you talked to me at the Derby, and I wrote a really happy start for him through the series last year, and he said you could do the same this year on Werther. We were disappointed we didn't win last start. I must admit, he ran a great race in the mile, of course, and he came here today with a 4 on the board.
It looked, watching from the stands, it was pretty much according to plan.
That's right. I was a bit worried in the early stages. I let him stride out of the barriers and then he wanted to get on with it. I got into a little bit of a wrestle with him, and we've seen the replay. But once I got him settled into a rhythm from the mile, I suppose, we were in business then, and it was just a case of waiting until I got a bit of room, and the horse certainly didn't let me down as he has in the past.
2,000 metres, obviously playing right into his hands. Do you think he's a sort of horse that can come back to a mile, or should be ready to concentrate on the 2,000 and whatever else might be?
I think he could be effective in a mile. I think he'll be more effective in a fast run because the pace was moderate, to say the least. And I think if he got to a fast run 2,000, is when we'll see the best of him. But certainly he'll be effective over a mile. And a half, I do have my doubts, but I'm sure John might be able to
work
his magic if he wants to go that
direction. There's not too many mile and a half races here.
No, that's right. They're in only a month or so. John knows the horse, he knows him well, but I think we've got a really top-class mile and 10 furlong horse in our heads.
And fingers crossed we're going to be seeing a little bit more of the odd pair under those circumstances.
Yeah, I'd certainly hope so. Hong Kong's been great to me, as I said, in the short time, times that I've been here, and to win the Hong Kong Derby is certainly a highlight.
That's a big thing to say. I love you, Hugh Bowman. Great work on Hugh Bowman.
Thank you,
of course. You've got to remember, this started last year, you know, when people like Gary and everybody got out, scout, to find these Derby horses. And to think that you can run first and second with a two New Zealand horses, actually, is just amazing. It's good for the New Zealanders, it's good for the horse stable, and from that point of view, I'm just absolutely thrilled to put together and to win another Derby.
What
would
be next for this one?
Huey 2? Huey 2 for sure. And the other horse, of course, running second. Victory Magic would have run second, by the way. Also, he'll go up along the ratings, but definitely Werther will go towards the cure.
You've talked just briefly about the second horse, but it's still amazing. You said when he was drawn so well, he's the one that could just surprise. Well, very nearly did.
Because a few people came to me and said, this horse really puts it together. And as I said, puts it together, he's going to be a live chance in the race. And Zach came back and said, he tried to lay down 4 times on me, and I had to keep screaming at him and make him do it. Because he mentioned when he came back that I thought the other horse was maybe going to get up and beat me. But he didn't, and we know where the really got down, he fought to the line, and the end result was